Good morning, children. Welcome to Gopikrishna Online Classes. Today we are here to discuss one more important topic from synthetic fibers and plastics. Petrochemicals. What is petrochemical? So we know one thing about the preparation of synthetic fiber. Synthetic fiber is prepared from the chemicals or minerals. Such materials are called petrochemicals. Synthetic fibers prepared by a number of processes using raw materials such as petroleum origin products are called petrochemicals. Understood, children? Synthetic fibers is prepared by using a number of processes using raw materials as petroleum origin products are called petrochemicals, or simply the materials which are used prepare the synthetic fibers are called petrochemicals. Next, characteristics of synthetic fibers. For that simple, I will ask one question, children. In a rainy day, so in that rainy day, we'll use one umbrella. Which kind of umbrella do you use, children? Which class is used to prepare that umbrella, as it is natural fiber cloth or synthetic fiber cloth? Definitely, our answer is the umbrella is made with a synthetic fiber cloth. Why? Because synthetic fiber cloth is used to prepare that umbrella. And other children, because if you used a cotton fiber or a natural fiber to prepare the umbrella, that cloth may absorb more water and it sent to the down. But synthetic fiber cloth cannot absorb more water. Understood, children? Now here some more characteristics of synthetic fibers are there. Synthetic fibers are less absorb water. And second important characteristic is Easily available. Third one is cheap in cost. Fourth one is easy to maintain. Easy to maintain. Dry up easily. Easy to wash. Next important characteristic is does not wrinkle. These are the some important characteristics of a synthetic fiber. Less absorb water, easily available, cheap in cost, easy to maintain, dry up easily, easy to wash, and does not wrinkle. Synthetic fibers does not get wrinkled. These are the some important of characteristics of a synthetic fiber. Please, children, write down these characteristics and learn what are the characteristics of a synthetic fiber. They are less absorb water, easily available, cheap in cost, easy to maintain, dry up easily, easy to wash, and does not wrinkle. These are the some characteristics of a synthetic fiber. Next, now we will perform an activity to know the characteristics of synthetic fibers. So, what we need to do that activity is take two beakers. 3 by 4th of the peacock is filled with water. Same in this beaker also, 3 by 4th of the beaker is filled with water. Three by fourth of the two beakers is filled with water. Now take two different glass about half meter long. So in the two fibers, one cloth is from natural fiber and another cloth is from synthetic fiber. So that take two cloths and soak into the two different beakers. So for example, in the beaker, it is beaker A, it is beaker B. So in the beaker A, we are dipping the cotton cloth. It is cotton cloth. Cotton cloth is dipped into the beaker A. In the beaker B, dip one nylon cloth. Nylon cloth is dipped into the beaker B. So after dipping up two fibers into the beakers, now after 5 minutes, so keep after dipping up two fibers into the beakers, keep like that 5 minutes. After 5 minutes, you have to remove the cloth outside and expose to the sunlight. Expose to the sunlight. So after 5 minutes, go near to the fibers and observe. Touch the fibers with your fingers. Which one dried up fastly? And after removal of fibers from the beakers, observe the volume of water present in the beaker. In which beaker more water is absorbed by the fiber? In which beaker the volume of the water is decreased? After 5 minutes, remove the fibers and expose to the sunlight. After that, observe the volume of water present in the two beaker. In the first beaker A, we dipped cotton fiber. In the beaker B, we dipped nylon fiber. And then after 5 minutes, observe the volume of, in first case, both have the equal amount of water, but after dipping the fibers into the beakers, again observe the volume of water present in the beaker. Is there any change in the volume of water in the beakers? Yes. In which beaker the volume has decreased? Our answer is in beaker A. In beaker A, the volume of water is decreased when compared to beaker B. So where does the decreased water go? The decreased water is absorbed by the cotton fiber. Cotton fiber is a natural fiber. Understood, children? So what you understood from this activity? Absorbing capacity of water by different fibers. Which fiber absorbs the more water? Either natural fiber or synthetic fiber? Natural fiber is absorbed more water than the synthetic fibers. Which fiber is dried up fastly? Either synthetic fiber or natural fiber? Synthetic fiber dried up fastly because synthetic fiber absorbed less water when compared to the natural fiber. Due to less amount of water absorbed by the synthetic fiber, it can dried up very fastly than the natural fiber. Find out some more properties or characteristics of synthetic fiber by performing this kind of activities. Understood, children, up to here? What is synthetic fiber? And we also discussed about some different kind of synthetic fibers like rayon, nylon, polyester, acrylic, and also disadvantages of synthetic fiber and characteristics of a synthetic fiber. What is the main disadvantage of synthetic fiber? The main disadvantage of synthetic fiber is it can catch fire very easily. It can catch fire quickly. It is the major disadvantage of the synthetic fiber. What are the characteristics of synthetic fibers? Earlier we discussed. Less absorb water, easy to maintain, easy to wash, easy to it can dry up very fastly, it does not get wrinkled. This is about the synthetic fibers. Understood, children? Yes. Here, one more important topic from this lesson 2, that is plastic. Plastic. Up to now we discussed about synthetic fiber, how the synthetic fibers are prepared, how the synthetic fiber was prepared. Then what is plastic? How the plastics prepared? Is there any new method to prepare the plastics? What are the materials are used to prepare the plastics? What is the process to use? About that we are going to discuss now. So plastics. Plastic is nothing but a synthetic fiber. Plastic also is synthetic fiber. You must be familiar with the many plastic articles used every day. Yes or no? Nowadays, without plastics, it is not possible to make our life easily. To survive. Yes or no? Everything nowadays we are depending upon the plastics. To do any work, to store anything, to play, we depend on plastics. Like that, the plastics are occupying our daily life. It's very dangerous, children. Don't depend on more uses of plastics. So, you must be familiar with the using of plastic in your day-to-day life. Make a list of such articles, such plastic articles. What are using daily? What you are using, then make a list of the plastics. So plastic is also a polymer of synthetic fiber. Nothing but it's not any new material. Plastic is also a polymer of synthetic fiber. How the synthetic fibers be prepared? Like that, we can also prepare the plastics because it also a polymer of synthetic fiber. But all plastics have same kind of arrangements. How the polymer synthetic fiber will prepared by the joining of small units. The small units are joined together and they form one long chain. That long chain is called polymer. Like that, in plastics also, these polymers are formed by the joining of small units. But these small units are not arranged in all kind of plastics. All plastics does not have same arrangement of small units. Different plastics may have different arrangement. Different plastics may have different arrangement of small units. Understood, children? So, different plastics may have different arrangement of plastics. Different arrangement of small units. So, are you observe the shape of the plastic articles? All plastic articles may have the shape? No. Plastic articles may available in different shapes and sizes. Different articles may are available in different shapes and sizes. Have you ever wondered how one material is available in this much of variety of sizes and shapes? How it is possible? Because plastic has one nature, it can be moldable into any shape and sizes. It can be moldable into any shape, any kind of shape and sizes. And also it can be available in different colors. And also plastics has some properties. Some plastics, so not all plastic articles, some plastics have some properties. Plastics can be recycled, reused. Plastics can be recycled, reused, melted, rolled into sheets and made to white. twice. It can be recycled, reused, molded into sheets, rolled into sheets for making vials, melted and heated. These are some plastics of some properties of plastics. See here, some examples are given. So that is why you find here plastics of varied. Because of these properties are made, the plastic particles are used for many purposes. So already I told one point. What point I told? All plastics have the same arrangement? No. Different particles have different arrangement of small units. Some plastics may have the arrangement of small units in linearly. Some plastics have small units arranged in linear arrangement. Linear arrangement. Got it, children? Some plastics may have the arrangement in cross-linked arrangement. This arrangement is cross-linked arrangement. Observe the figures, children. In first case, the small units are arranged straight in a straight line linearly. These kind of arrangement is called linear arrangement. Observe, children, here how the small units are arranged here, cross-linked. In this type of plastics, small units are arranged in cross-linked. These kind of arrangement is called cross-linked arrangement. All plastic does not have a same arrangement of small units. In different plastics, the small units are arranged differently. In some plastics, the small units are arranged linearly. That arrangement is called linear arrangement. In some plastics, small units are linked cross. That kind of arrangement is called cross-linked arrangement. Cross-linked arrangement. Understood, children? Up to now we discussed the what is plastic, how the plastics are made. Yes or no, children? How the plastics are made? By the joining of small units. Maybe it is linearly or cross-linked. Yes or no, children? Yes. So up to now we discussed about the so many things. Okay, children. Please watch the video very carefully and make down some important points. Okay, children. We'll continue the next video. Thank you.